Period. Hey y'all, what's up? It's me, Grace Malati, period poo, periodically, periata, period, no tampon, period, no menstrual cycle. It's me, Grace Malati, period. So today I'm going to be telling a story that is wide known, you know, everybody knows this. everybody knows the story, except y'all. Wait, but I'm going to tell it right now. So one day I was in college. Okay, I still am in college, but like, yeah. So one day I applied for college and, you know, got accepted, yada, 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 had to do housing, yada, 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 procrastinated, yada, yada, yada. When I did my housing application, along with the housing application, you're supposed to choose a roommate. And unfortunately, I didn't go through all the troubles of like trying to find a roommate through Instagram or Facebook. Like, I was just like, you know what? Randomize me with anybody. Cause baby, I'm an outgoing person. Like, I don't really care like who I get, you know? Like, I'ma still make friends, but apparently not. Anyway, leading up to move out day, I got an email from
laying here editing this video. I realized I said move out day. It's actually move in day. You know, I got it wrong or whatever. Oh well, it's move in day, not move out day. Damn, you get it. It's move in day. Damn.
I got an email from the random girl that was supposed to be my roommate. Let's call her Lily. Lily, you know, Lily emailed me her Instagram. So I looked it up and, you know, when you judge a book by its cover, that's what I was doing. I was judging a book by its cover because by her Instagram, I could tell that she was kind of like an introvert, if that makes sense. Like, I don't really, introvert is the word, right? Yeah, she was kind of like shy, kind of like to herself. And that's not me. So, but like, I could just tell that she was not for me. And like, I knew it was bad to judge a book by its cover, but girl, like, I'm sorry. Like, I knew she was weird from the jump. No jump in. I knew she was weird from the bat. No baseball. Like, I just knew that she was weird from the start, basically. And like, just her Instagram posts were just like, come on. But so, you know, I was like, you know what? I'm not going to stress it. I'm not going to ask for a new roommate right now. I'm just going to go move in. Move in was like a week after. So I was just like, you know what? I'm just going to let it go. It's okay. It's just, you know, she's a little weird. We can change that. Give her a makeover. No, I'm just joking. I just was like, you know, it's going to be okay. Like, I just let it blow off. I was just like, whatever. So come move-in day, you know, we moved in. I met her and her family. And we moved in on the same day. And they were like really cool, really nice. You know, I didn't really think too much of her at that time. I was just like, oh, she's nice. She's cute. Well, she's nice. And she's nice or whatever. And I just basically thought she was a nice girl. So fast forward to the next day. The next day, I think we started classes. And I remember she had a class before mine because her alarm went off. So she woke up first. And I remember just laying in bed because the alarm kind of woke me up. And she came up to me and kissed me goodbye.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
But like, you don't do that. Like, you just met me and you're gonna kiss me on the forehead. She was like this. She kissed me on my forehead, bro. As soon as she walked out the door, I wiped it off so motherfucking quick. So motherfucking quick, I wiped that shit off. But yeah. So that's what happened. She kissed me on my forehead. I was just like, what the fuck? You know, like, you don't do that. Like, I would not kiss you on the forehead goodbye, especially if we just meet. Like, I can understand if we're like besties or whatever. Even then, it's kind of like, what the fuck? But but I mean, you know, I guess that was her way of showing like some type of endearment. I don't know, but I really didn't like it. I thought it was inappropriate. I didn't like it at all. Here comes the next big incident that was basically the whole sum of the story, why she got kicked out of my room, why I kicked her out of my room, and why it was just like a whole big thing. This was the big story. You know, this was in the middle of the semester. Me and my boyfriend, we went to different parties or whatever. It was just something between me and my boyfriend, and we kind of got into a little argument. And, you know, I was kind of tipsy. You know, I was kind of a little drunk, a little litty. So I went back to my dorm after the argument. And basically, I explained to my roommate what happened because I needed a friend to talk to. Mind you, I was tipsy. So, like, I was just spilling everything. And I was like, oh, my God. Like, we got in an argument and we were yelling at each other. Yada, yada, yada. So I was just telling her all this shit. And all of a sudden, the next week after I told her that, I get a call from my boyfriend and he's saying, come downstairs, come to my room. The police are here. What the fuck? The police are here, baby. No. Why are the police here? So I go to his room and unfortunately, the police said that he got a report saying that my boyfriend was domestically abusing me. I was like, what? No, like, it was just so bad. Like, first of all, my boyfriend does not domestically abuse me at all. First of all, baby, let's get that straight. Let's get that straight. First of all, I don't even get domestically abused. I will hit back. So I don't get domestically abused. So I knew that was false. I knew that report was just no. So basically, I'm just like, no, like, we explained our story. Like, we got in an argument or whatever. It was yada, yada, yada. And somewhere it came up that he hit me or something. And I was like, who the fuck would, and then a light just went on. A light just went on. I was like, it was motherfucking Lily who told the police that fucking I was getting domestically abused. And it was just, I was just so humiliated. Like, I'm not abused. Like, why would she call the police on my boyfriend from domestic violence just because, you know, we got an argument? Like, all fucking relationships have arguments. Like, why is that such a big thing? So she basically called the police and I was like, you know what, this is the last straw. And I know y'all are like, probably like, oh well, this is not enough to get her. I know y'all are probably like, oh well, this is not enough to like kick somebody out of your room for. Yes it is. Shoot, y'all did not know her. Everything leading up to when she called the police was just like things, little things that she would say, little things that she would do. She was just weird, bro. Like, I feel like she would watch me in my sleep, bro. I'm telling you, one day I was sleeping on the other side, like I was like turned this way and I turned around and she was looking at me like, why are you watching me when I sleep? Like, it was just little weird things like that, like, kind of creeped me out leading up to this incident, which really made me like, it was like the cherry on top. I was like, no baby, we're not doing this. Like, you got to get out. So basically that's what happened. I told my RA, which is a residential, I don't know, I told my RA, which is like the kind of like the overseer of the floor. I told my RA. And she was like, okay, yeah, we can like talk about it and then we can get her situated out and yada, yada, yada. So that's what happened. She moved out. And now I have my own room. But that's what happened. And it was just really crazy. Like, the things that she would do, like, it was just weird. Like, I feel like it was just bad. Like, it was just two opposites together in a room. Two opposite people. Like, bro, like, she was just weird, bro. Weird. So after that happened, that's how I got my own room. That's that. And I just, ever since then, you know, I'm scared to have a roommate. Apparently, I'm getting one the next semester. I'm actually very scared about that. But, you know, what can you do? At this point, nothing can be worse than Lily, man. And, oh, yeah, tell me why a person that I know that's in her class said she wrote a story about me and presented it to the class. Okay, that's kind of what I'm doing right here. But, like, that's different. Like, she actually wrote a story about me. Like, about me as her roommate and presented it to the class. Like, I don't know. I think that's kind of funny. Like, I actually think that's actually really funny. But, like, what? See, I just think I should have my own room, period, point blank. Like, I just... But, yeah, that's what happened with my roommate, since everybody on my Snapchat wants to know what happened to my roommate. That's what happened. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this dumb video of me explaining about my roommate. What's it called? I should be coming out with more videos because I want to be a YouTuber or whatever. So I should be coming out with more videos. Let me know what you guys want me to do, because I'll do it, baby. I'll do it. But yeah, I'm going to be coming out with more videos. This is just the beginning, baby. This is just the beginning. So let me know what y'all want to see, and thanks for watching. Close. And just send him a